Hey YouTube, welcome to another video on knowledge management. Today I'll show you how I combine Obsidian Canvas with a few powerful learning techniques to create a learning machine. I've been brushing up on some biology fundamentals through an audio lecture I found on Audible. My goal is to internalize as much as possible of that lecture I can for the long run. Now, there are multiple techniques for learning something more effectively, but studies show that using multiple techniques over just one technique is more effective. In this video, I'll show you a few science-based techniques that you can implement to learn something in the long run. For my note-taking tool, I'll be using Obsidian Canvas. Now, Obsidian Canvas is a new feature added in late 22 that allows for a more visual approach to note-taking. Let's take a look. All right, so to get started, just select the Obsidian Canvas from the left bar. First, to rename the canvas to Biology 101. So I'm going to start by creating a new group. This group is going to be the place where I'm going to start building my explanation of the subject that I'm reviewing. In this case, I studied the discovery of the hereditary properties of DNA. And now within this group, I can start creating my explanation of what I just learned. So I listened to this lecture series on the fundamentals of biology, and this is one of the ideas presented. And so the idea is now to explain with my own words this concept. This first part is called active recall, or in other words, the Feynman technique. And I brought up the Feynman technique in a previous video. Go check that out, a link up in the corner. And basically what the Feynman technique is explaining the concept that you've just learned to better internalize that idea. Not only explaining the concept, but explaining it as if your audience did not understand anything from the subject. Or for example, explaining it to like a five-year-old. So to start, I start creating a card and just double click to create a card. And this particular experiment was called the Oswald Avery experiment. So finally, I've created an explanation using the canvas or visual style of explaining. And now I'm going to create a new note in my system. To create a note, you can start by just creating a card. So double click, create a card, and then you can right click to convert it into a file. And now I can just rename the note. And I'm going to call this note the transforming factor, which was the concept that was discovered at that time. And the transforming factor was basically the realization that DNA contained information, and that information was then transferred to the other cells. And now this is a node in your system. You can add tags, hashtag biology, hashtag DNA, and now just add the concepts given here. And what I can just do is basically just copy paste the ideas. You can add images. And the great thing about Obsidian Canvas is you can also include links into the canvas itself. And it creates a visual representation of the web page. So I have an article by Nature here that talks about this concept here, and I can just add it into the canvas itself. So just copy and paste. And the great thing about these web links is that you can interact with the content within the website inside Obsidian Canvas. And this can be useful for copy-pasting some highlights or anything from the web page to your canvas or your notes themselves. Just to indicate that you've created a note in Obsidian, We can just go into your files and then we can find this transforming factor note within your notes. And Obsidian Canvas is a great place to create these notes. All right, so what we've done now is we've created an explanation from the memory. So basically I've just actively recalled what I learned about this subject. And the next phase or the next technique I'm going to show you is called spaced repetition. Now, you've probably heard about spaced repetition earlier. And what spaced repetition basically is, it's flashcards. Spaced repetition has been shown to improve long-term recollection or learning, given that you do it in the correct way. Now, there are multiple spaced repetition tools out there. One of the most common ones being Anki, for example. But the great thing about Obsidian is that we have the community plugins, and there is a spaced repetition community plugin. So next phase, we're gonna call spaced repetition. Now we're gonna start by installing a plugin. I haven't already installed, I'll show you how to do it. So go to settings, go to community plugins, browse, and then search for spaced repetition. And to install spaced repetition, just press install and then enable. So let's create a new note into the canvas itself. And you can do is grab this icon here in the bottom and then just drag it into place. And now we're going to call this Biology 101 flashcards. And we're just going to create the note into the canvas itself. Now it's important it's a note because the plugin itself uses the notes to create the flashcards. So there are a couple of things we need to do. So first one is to add the hashtag flashcards. What this does, it tells the plugin itself that we're using this note as a flashcard base. Now to create the questions and answers in the flashcard, we just separate the question and the answer with a double colon. Now that's the question, and to create the answer, double colon, and then just put the answer right under it. Now we're going to make a couple more. All right, to review the flashcards, just click the icon and choose the flashcards. And depending on how well you answer the question, the system adjusts the repetition time to 1 day, 2.5 days, or 3.5 days in this case. I did quite a good job answering this question, so just click good and it will jump to the next question. And doing daily reviews of your flashcards is the best way to memorize something in the long run. So now this is the system I created for the Biology 101. You can apply this to any subject you're learning, reading research papers or books. And here I have another example. I used the same system to learn the fundamentals of mathematics. So we have the active recall area here and then a revision area here with the flashcards. So no matter what tool you decide to use, these techniques work universally. And remember, combining multiple techniques instead of just using one technique for learning is more powerful. Obsidian Canvas has proven to be a great visual learning tool. And then combining two really powerful learning techniques, you can create a learning machine. Hopefully you found this video useful or interesting. If you did, click like and consider subscribing for more content like this in the future. Take care. Bye.